some news for sweet tooths out there. The Philippine government is eyeing to tax junk food and sweetened beverage. This proposal by the Finance and Health Departments as they seek to address diabetes, obesity, and other diseases among Filipinos related to having a poor diet. Now, under that program, prepackaged foods such as confectioners, snacks, desserts could be taxed 10 pesos per 100 grams. Now, these were identified as prepackaged foods lacking nutritional value, which exceed the threshold for fat, salt, and sugar content. Similarly, the Finance Department also intends to increase the tax rate for sweetened beverage to 12 pesos per liter. Now, the government expects the program to generate 76 billion pesos in its first year of implementation. No word yet on when that's happening. It's also seen to reduce junk food consumption by 21%. The DOF says revenues from this will be used to fund socioeconomic programs and provide support to a million poor households. Here at home, President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. says he will sign the controversial Maharlika Investment Fund bill as soon as he receives it. Marcos himself, though, acknowledged there were valid concerns raised in the establishment of the fund. But he says it all boils down to the fund's management.
I've been watching the discussions that have been going on the Maharlika Fund. And I say, that's all true. That's all true. You must worry about that. But the only way to make sure that we do not get into trouble, or the fund does not get into trouble, is that it's well and professionally managed. Kung korap ang ilagay mo dyan, korap talaga yan. Mana, mamawala yung pera. Kung mahusay ang ilalagay mo dyan, ay lalaki at lalaki yan at magagamit natin yung pondong yan.
Stocks in Asia decline as investors digest the latest remarks of Federal Reserve Chairman Jerome Powell. Powell told lawmakers on Wednesday the Fed may need to further hike its rates to meet its inflation target of 2%. Taking a look now at major stock indices in the region, Australia's ASX 200 leads losses on Thursday, shedding 1.6%. Now even the Japanese Nikkei 225 not spared, down by close to 1%. Meanwhile, the Chinese markets, Shanghai Composite and Hang Seng, are closed for a public holiday. Over in Europe, futures point to a lower open as traders await the Bank of England's policy decision. The Bank of England is expected to hike rates once more after Britain's inflation last month remained high at 8.7%. In Wall Street, the major indices are down in pre-market open after closing lower overnight for the third straight day. Trading resumes tonight, Manila time.